Armstrong Hall is a gateway to Purdue, both physically and academically. Its location on the campus at one corner means that it's one of the first academic buildings that people see when they enter Purdue from that direction. Also, Armstrong Hall houses the first year engineering program. So all engineering students that come to Purdue start by going through Armstrong Hall. That means they're in Armstrong Hall when they enroll in Purdue. But perhaps more importantly, they're in Armstrong Hall when they're still in high school or junior high and they visit Purdue on recruiting visits to consider it as an opportunity. Students come to Purdue for a world-class education in all of the engineering disciplines. The students that Armstrong is attracting are very special. They're interested in participating in all aspects of aerospace engineering.
It was the obvious choice. It's known as the cradle of astronauts and also has a very strong relationship with the co-op program at the Johnson Space Center, which I'm currently a part of, and that was one of my goals. And my parents are both alumni, so it was a very obvious choice to come to Purdue.
I decided to attend Purdue University because it was one of the engineering schools I looked at, and after I visited, I fell in love, and it was definitely one of the schools I wanted to go to. I've planned to go to grad school and onward to my PhD. I plan to, hopefully I will be able to become an astronaut. I would love to try and go there.
When I found out about Purdue, I found out more that it was a lot of astronauts came from Purdue, and I figured I might as well head that way because it worked for them, and why wouldn't it work for me? In the future, I hope to be like Neil because he's a good role model, but hope to maybe trump him a little bit and be the first person on another planet rather than just the moon.
Being a professor is a great job. We're around students all the time. The students bring lots of energy. They always bring new ideas. Every year that we graduate students, we then start with a new crop of students, and it's always a brand new opportunity. It's really exciting for me to think about all the things that these students will be doing after they graduate. And that's what keeps me excited about my job.
And it's a really exciting time again now with the initiative to go back to the moon and to Mars. And you know, these students are leaving Purdue now going to really exciting positions in NASA, in the big rocket engine companies, as well as a lot of these small startup companies that are privately funded for space tourism and so forth. So new Purdue engineers today are making a huge impact in the industry, just as was done back in the earlier days.
The opportunities that abound today are almost beyond belief. Some of them may have a chance to go to Mars, or some of them may have a chance to do other kinds of things in space that we can't even foresee now.
Always looking toward the future, Purdue University is preparing Indianapolis middle school students through its science-bound project. Students who excel in this program have the opportunity to earn full scholarships to Purdue to study for careers in engineering, science, math, technology, and math science education. These students may very well be the next generation of Purdue scientists, engineers, educators, and astronauts.
For 100 years now, Purdue graduates have been involved in aviation and space. From the early days when Purdue graduates sat on the wings of planes and held onto the controls as they flew hundreds and thousands of feet in the air, holding onto the controls to keep themselves from falling out. The wind blowing in their face, bugs flowing in their eyes. Trying to land those planes, trying to advance this new technology. To the earliest days of passenger flight, to the earliest days of airmail flight. To the earliest days of space flight, when we finally orbited the Earth, when we finally left the atmosphere and went into this new era, to the days when we first got to the moon and people walked on the moon, to the last person to walk on the moon, to the space shuttle, which goes to the space station and is advancing our knowledge of the universe, to our exploration of Mars that is taking place right now. Now we're in a new century. It's a new time. And Purdue is getting ready to launch a whole new era in aviation and space on our campus.
We'll be right back with more of Purdue Pathways, the Space Connection. Purdue University, home to the world's largest compilation of Amelia Earhart's papers, memorabilia, and artifacts, is proud to be the recipient of two new historic treasures. Purdue graduates Neil Armstrong and Eugene Cernan, the first and the most recent men to walk on the moon, have donated their personal papers to the university's archives and special collections. These extraordinary contributions by Armstrong and Cernan are wonderful additions to 55 hours of taped interviews with Armstrong that were donated by author James R. Hansen.
Purdue University has an unrivaled reputation in aviation, aeronautics, and astronautics. It's a reputation earned by exceptional men and women who continue to inspire us today. From small steps to giant leaps, the journey began right here at Purdue, where our space connection grows ever stronger. Thank you for joining us.